so many survivors are in that same predicament where it goes undiagnosed. So by the time I was diagnosed and the doctor said, he saw the cyst in my brain, mm-hmm. everything came out, and he's like, well, you have a TBI. And my parents and I, what is TBI? I have no idea.
Right, yeah.
You had severe whiplash, you had, I didn't ride a roller coaster, why, what are you talking about? And he was explaining what whiplash was, and just the whole, and because of the fall, it messed up, you know, my whole body. So
now, you're a professional drummer, too, so
yeah.
As a result of this injury, which, as you said, went undiagnosed, which is very, very common, folks, so could you play drums anymore?
Only for myself, I can. It's very hard because it's the love of my life.
Yeah. And in terms of what has been damaged, in terms of, now you're wearing your hat and your glasses, and now you have sunglasses, because you say that one of the things you discovered was those kind of things are now too bright that your brain can't process it.
Yeah, the light and noise sensitivity is debilitating for me. I can only last so long during the day, but I wear sunglasses on the floor all the time. I tell, even if you don't have the light and noise sensitivity, which 99% of us do,
mm-hmm.
Our whole body is kind of like a charged battery. Throughout the day, it just lessens and lessens and lessens.
Oh.
So you really have to, if you're not wearing, like if I'm not wearing my sunglasses now, it's just draining that battery more.
Yeah.
And
now, you didn't just settle back and say, okay, I've got a traumatic brain injury. And this is when I got interested in this, folks, is you have an organization called Handled With Love. Because what happens with TBI victims, I'll call them that, is that when they have, I look at you and I go, everything is absolutely normal. Yet, while I'm talking to you or somebody else, you could short circuit and then we'd be going, well, what's wrong with him?
Right.
So you came up with an idea, and I'm gonna hold this up right now. This is what's called a TBI, a traumatic brain injury, kind of a card that you can carry with you. It says Handle With Love, because you might get into a situation where you have a brain injury and something goes wrong, and nobody knows it. So they treat you differently. They may think that you're a criminal. They may think that you're drunk, because that's what kind of happens to you at times, doesn't it?
Right. There was one time where I was at a restaurant. It was 5 o'clock last year, actually, Christmas, and I just had a long day, and I was starting to slur and stutter my speech, and they thought I was drunk, and they refused to serve us, and so we all had to leave.
So besides having this organization Handled With Love, you also go around and talk to people, because as far as TBIs are concerned, you're kind of an exception because you've survived, but you can talk in front of people where a lot of times when people have TBIs, they either can't talk or they have slurred speech or they're just afraid and they can't do it.
Yeah, I'm very, very blessed in that way. You know, God sent me a very, you know, trial and tribulation type moment, and, you know, it's by His will that I'm here.
Well, you have a purpose in your life.
Yeah.
I mean, that's
yeah.
the big deal. Now, you've talked to the different sheriff's departments, haven't you?
Yes.
And because we had a situation where somebody was shot and killed, we had the video that showed on our air and all over the nation where it was an African-American going back to his car, and you could hear his wife saying on the phone, now don't do anything, he's had a brain injury, leave him alone, he's had a brain injury. And what happened is he reached in, maybe he wasn't reaching for a gun, but reaching for something, and they shot and killed him.
Right.
You know, had he had something like this, where, you know, at least there would have been the pause. And tell me about the situation where one of the lectures that a kid actually reached out.
I gave a lecture a couple weeks ago at Largo PD with all the surrounding county sheriff and police officers and troopers. And a few days later, I got a email from one of the sheriffs, and she was in a situation where a child reached for her
taser.
And what happens with TBI survivors, there's a lot of, you know, groping or a lot of things because your brain goes back to being a child.
Yeah.
And that situation, she said, would have been vastly different if she didn't hear about traumatic brain injury.
Well, and I have interviewed other vets who have had TBI because we think of it with the war in Afghanistan, particularly because of the violent shaking that goes on, and when an improvised explosive device goes off, it goes, well, he wasn't burned or anything, but the volume and what it can do to your head. So you've got this, the organization, you've got these cards that you're passing out right now. What's your ultimate goal? If you could put a magic wand on this thing and say, okay, this is what I want to accomplish.
Well, Handle With Love, I created it for, you know, the traumatic brain injury identification card that saved lives.
Yeah.
I mean, it's so important, and I want every survivor to be able to have one of those. some survivors can't even afford $25.
Yeah.
So on the website, I have, you know, a link where people can go donate to help survivors. The financial obligation is so hard because it's ongoing. You think you're, after the bruises and things go away and heal outside, it doesn't end. Things come out, like we chatted earlier about, you know, last week I was at a wedding and things just escalated and put me into a panic attack, and I'm not used to having a panic attack.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So,
and you have to learn how to live what's called the new normal.
Correct. Yeah.
And but do you even know what the new normal can be, because your brain doesn't think the way it used to?
It changes. I could taste something today and then next week taste it and completely hate it.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what's so hard. So my goal with Handle With Love is, you know, to create awareness, but to give a purpose back to survivors, because survivors become suicidal. I mean, that's just 100% goes through our brains many times, because mm-hmm. the abandonment of family and friends, again, that financial obligation breaks families up. My own parents almost divorced over it.
Yeah.
And that's common. And it's sad, because the rest of your life you deal with this thing that you can't control.
Do you think medicine understands it enough? Because I know you did some work at Vanderbilt University they helped you out with, but there's only so far the medicine goes.
Yeah, we know as much about the brain as we do the ocean, period.
That's it.
Yeah. And we are learning every day different things. My goal with Handle With Love is first to give awareness in these cards, but I wanted to start a company that gave purpose back to survivors. So I want to employ survivors to help make these cards, to sell shirts and help them financially with they need.
Just a purpose in life is a big
deal.
Your website is gregcosta.net, is that right?
That's my website. The Handle With Love website is handlewithlovetbi.com.
Okay, handlewithlovetbi.com. Folks, and again, if you know anybody that's had a stroke or has had a traumatic brain injury of that was caused by a fall or a car accident or something, go to that website, and I think you're going to find this stuff to be very helpful. I think it's a great idea. I know three or four people right now that will benefit greatly from that.
And there is one thing. If you go to the resource page on there, that has been, there's an article that says, you know, everything a survivor wants you to know.
Okay, so that's
and,
good.
Yeah, National Geographic did an amazing thing with some veterans on how they felt, and they painted the pictures of how they feel every day.
Oh boy, yeah.
So
folks, go to the resource page. And Greg, thank you for coming by. It's good
thank
to see you.
Bro. Thank you. You're good. I love you.
Perfect. 8.5 minutes. It was very good. Very concise, to the point. Right, Pops?
Excellent. He does real good.